Hello, Internet.
Yes, hello, Internet. We are back for more spooky streaming. Mm. And today we shall be doing the Lake House.
Oh, let's see. Descend into the Federal Bureau of Control Research Facility and unravel the mysteries lurking within. Oh my god, looks good.
Okay, I just need to double check that audio is working.
This has been living in my head. Rent for the trailer, especially the first teaser trailer, has been living in my head rent free ever since it came out. so bad.
Yes, this one will only be on Twitch, but I'm sure we will still have fun.
Okay. Oh my god.
The next expansion from the email will overwrite your progress in existing expansion and quick save slot. Okay, I guess.
Oh my god.
This isn't the Bureau's first time in Bright Falls.
Hmm?
1970s, 6, 8. Last one was in 2010.
Hmm.
It's not exactly clockwork, but this town sees way more altered world events than most.
Yeah.
70 matches up.
It's just a matter of time before the lake acted up again. After the AWE in 2010, the FBC's research department set up a facility.
Good idea.
To study the threshold in Cauldron Lake, find better ways to contain the entity inside. Your tax dollars at work. When we detected a spike in paranormal activity at Cauldron Lake, before I even knew you were on this case, Saga.
Oh.
The lake house was my first stop.
I wonder if they're talking about it after the event.
Mm-hmm. Hope they could spare some help, maybe give us some intel on the situation.
Yes, she's talking to Saga.
Any clue what was waiting for us in there, Saga? Hana just kept on driving.
70s match up.
Yeah. They must be talking to Saga after the events, because she never went into this much detail during...
Mm-hmm.
This is Agent Kieran Estevez responding to an AWE alert in the vicinity. I need to speak with the Marmons. So much for the welcome wagon.
Oh boy.
FPC.
Doesn't this just seem... This is just right for a horror movie right now.
Yeah.
We're on the threshold's doorstep, so keep your eyes peeled.
Yes, ma'am.
I wonder if she went in there alone. We'll see.
Game saved. Oh! Oh! Return addendum, the lake house. Oh no.
This shouldn't take long, okay? You see anything? Radio me.
Yeah, she is going in alone.
Mm-hmm.
But she does say that her team... Didn't she say that her team died? Like, when she was talking to Saga? Because I feel like those poor people outside are not going to have a good time.
The lake house was run by the research department. Research and investigations don't really see eye to eye.
Oh,
what they call science... I call a violation of Bureau protocol and human decency. Classic interdepartmental drama. Your FBI saga, you know how it goes.
Oh my god.
My low opinion of the research department may have clouded my judgment.
To be fair, the research department guy tried to send Saga to the dark place, so... I open the truck. No.
Oh, so it was amazing. There was a speed limit sign back there. I think it said like 5 miles an hour. Oh boy.
Jeez, this place. When I heard Lake House, I thought maybe they had taken over Hartman's old place.
Yeah.
But I think they relocated that to Bright Falls. Like they like took it apart and relocated it, which is where the hotel was. But at the same time, this place is creepier than I thought
Agent
it would be.
Agent Kieran Estevez, Investigations Department.
Oh,
No one wants to check the individual carrying a firearm into a restricted government facility.
Okay, well, it's definitely going in the report.
Oh my god. I love the sassiness.
It's so good.
A vending machine.
No.
Oh, wait. Oh, I don't have unlimited ammo.
Yeah, no. Use your bullets wisely, sir. No shooting vending machines, at least not yet. You may have to shoot it later, but not yet. Ooh, let's see what this says. Okay. The Lake House Daily. Good news. HQ's still dark. Pie was good. More pie for the rest of us. We have coffee deer fest this week.
HQ's still dark. How is that a good thing?
What's bad news? Bad news. HQ's still dark. Nut allergy bad. No Ama beer. It's good. Tried it. The artist is illegible. Someone stole the black whiteboard marker. All vacation time canceled.
Someone stole the black marker.
Someone stole the black marker.
Oh, but they definitely have something to do with the artist, which may be from Alan Wakeman.
Not here.
Oh boy. Oh.
Nobody is.
Let's go to this one first.
Okay.
I'll have to check downstairs.
All right. Research response subject P. Through extensive testing, the subject has been confirmed to possess intrinsic paranatural ability that manifests exclusively during the act of painting. The paintings feature scenes or events that he would have no knowledge of, even sometimes painting an event before it occurs. This effect has been proven multiple times and has an estimated 40 to 100% success rate. Note the lack of precision in this range due to the team's inability to prove a painting's contents will not be realized at some point in the eventual future. Researchers asked to reiterate their hesitance to publish any concrete statements surrounding the subject and his ability at this time, as the nature of the paintings and their paranormal effects have been exceptionally difficult to measure and quantify.
Yeah.
Conclusion: the subject is suspected to be class 2 para-utilitarian, although additional testing will be required to confirm this. At this time, his ability is not believed to be a direct threat to himself or others and can be controlled. The nature of his ability to show current or future events via the arch key creates, but the extension of this forecasting cannot be determined by researchers with any high level of precision. Unlike the art created by Alan Wake, there is no evidence that the subject's art is directly manipulating reality via the shadow's energies.
Replacement key card request form. Please fill out the fields well before delivering the form to security. New card will be issued to you once request is processed. Jules Monument, position co-head of research, required clearance, the highest one, I forgot what it's called. Reason for replacement, your card went missing. Indicate here if your card was stolen, how would I know if it's stolen or is lost? Why do you not put microtropes inside to follow them if you're so concerned with this? I'm the head of research and I expect a new card on my desk by the end of the workday.
Okay. Ooh.
Oh, we need a password.
Okay. Oh, hello. What do we got here? Let's see. Update to computer password reset. Effective September 13th, all computer passwords must be reset daily to address security concerns. We are aware this may be an inconvenient change and lead to difficulty remembering your password. We recommend using a permanent set of digits as the beginning of the password, followed by numbers that change daily. Try using significant personal dates, coordinates, etc. Do not use birthdays, the current date, phone numbers, etc. Please also remember, for the time being, passwords are not to exceed 6 digits. Thank you for your compliance. If you want a secure password, have it be more than 6 digits.
Science fact of the day. The most famous for acting,
Heidi
Lamar, also invented in her free time. She patented a frequency hopping device for torpedo guidance systems at the age of 38.
Oh my god, that is so specific.
Yeah. I'm not seeing anything that would indicate any numbers as of now.
Unless it had something to do with the time date. It was September 14th. Just for kicks, let's try 09, 14, maybe 2-3?
That's not right.
Nope, okay.
damn it.
Okay.
Experiment. That bodes well.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, experiment in progress.
Yeah.
We know what that leads to. Okay, let's check over here. This might have something.
On the recommendation of the faculty and by the virtue of the authority vested in the trustees of Barrows University, have conferred on Jules François Marmont a degree of Doctor of Applied Science, and is entitled to all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. William Durex, Chairman of the Board of Trustees. Paul Jensen, Dean of Barrows University. Congratulations, okay. Man.
Federal Bureau of Control Special Service Certificate. Exceptional Contribution Candidate awarded to James Brooks of Marmont.
Jules. Yes.
In grateful recognition of his outstanding contribution to Bureau of Scientific Endeavors, Casper Darling.
Aww. Notice of appointment from Dr. Casper Darling, Head of Research, to Dr. Jules Marmont, Appointment of Facility Head. The senior leadership of the Federal Bureau of Control has determined to appoint Dr. Jules Marmont as the head of research at the facility of Culture in Lake Washington. The appointment will be shared by Diana Marmont, effective upon the facility's completion on July 18th. Zachariah Trench, Bureau Director, and Casper Darling.
Yeah.
Also, that was a cute picture. Did you see the picture?
Mm-hmm.
That was nice.
I have a feeling we're going to need to solve the computer puzzle to go down.
Hello, and welcome
to
another exciting day here at the lake house.
Why do you have this?
I am Dr. Jules Marmont, and this is my wife.
Hello, wife.
Dr. Diana Marmont.
And together
she's
we
so
are
not into this. Look at it.
Speakers.
We want to thank you all for helping us break new ground in our study of Cauldron Lake.
What are you doing?
But don't let our exciting work in threshold regulation and dimensional coupling keep you from observing the proper safety protocols.
Like pointing your gun at the speakers.
We run a tight ship here at the lake house. So, always remember the three S's.
Oh.
Safety, security, and censorship.
That's
sir.
A C.
Yes! You do not know how to... That's...
That is the joke, Diana.
Well, it's a stupid, wonderful joke. I'll see you down there.
Oh, did you... They did an edit there.
Yeah.
It seems healthy.
Yeah, I have to admit. That was a little messy. Ooh! Urgent reminder, lake safety protocols. Please remember that the following recreational activities are forbidden in the waters of Cauldron Lake. These restrictions apply to both civilians and FBC. Fishing, redacted. Swimming, boating, applies to canoes, kayaks, motorized boats, etc. Using the water for redacted purposes. Water skiing, redacted in the water. Paddle birding. These activities can result in redacted in an estimated redacted percent of cases. If you are unclear about any of the restrictions listed above, please speak with redacted.
I have the feeling redacted in the water is peeing in the water.
Yeah.
Okay.
But how are they supposed to speak with someone if they don't know who it is?
Yes. Security report, local rumors, background. A recent security operation was performed among the citizens of Bright Falls and Waterly. The goal of the operation was to ascertain public knowledge and opinion of the lake house and its operations. Summary, following information was gained through covert listening and informal questioning. Local public appeared to view the area around the lake house with fear. This is, of course, with intended reaction as the Bureau has publicly marked this area as dangerous due to volcanic gases. However, there's a specific rumor among the public regarding a government facility in the woods run by mad scientists taking people for experimentation. This rumor seems to be particularly popular among the local youth, and its proximity to the truth could cause for concern.
Its proximity to the truth. Oh, God.
Worst case outcome would be to increase in curiosity or possible even aggression. It's possible that even the reason for the lake house's security breach back in blank.
Ooh.
Action to be taken. Security personnel will continue to monitor your youth chatter. If the rumors continue, Dismantling a cover story may be required, perhaps even fabricating a signature for an American Volcano Commission type institution.
Oh, maybe they're referring to, do you remember, you may not, I don't know, because we, because I, because it was a while ago, but we did come across a, we did come across a notice from the Cult of the Tree saying, don't break into the lighthouse and mess with their equipment. That's probably what, they, that's probably what they're referring to.
Okay, status report. To all staff, on-site observation teams report that the oldest house is still under active lockdown.
Oh my god.
Status of Director Trench, management team, and all other personnel in the oldest house. At the time of lockdown initiation remains unknown. Observation teams have detected fluctuations in blank field originating from the oldest house as a blank, increasing in strength as it loops through a specific pattern every blank hours. These readings are currently being analyzed by research staff at Boston office. Any personnel with it... if information pertaining to these signals, should contact them immediately.
Oh, no. You know what's weird? They don't know. Like, when Jesse became a director... Oh, cool, we have a map.
Yeah.
When Jesse became a director, everybody in the oldest house seemed to immediately know. But somehow that phenomenon does not extend to other FBC...
Well, if it's in lockdown, that makes sense, I think.
It is still interesting that the news... spread so quickly across
well, all the pictures and stuff change,
which is interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, for let's try 14/20/23.
Okay. Valid.
Come on. Oh, wait, why is there a one there? All right. Nope. I don't know what on earth this code could be. I'm not seeing like any indications of anything. And I want to, like, try and use it before we go down.
What if we try 13? Because that's the day on the notice. Come on. What about 09/13/23?
That's not right.
Nope. Okay. Do you want me to look it up?
You know what, why not? Just because I want to see what's on the computer, but I'm not really seeing much of an indication of what it would be. Was it just 13/13/13?
It could be. It could be. Alrighty. Oh, look, a bust. Computer password. 092225.
Damn it.
No? Oh, son of a beehive. I'm looking at the wrong one. I'm loathing it.
Okay. 07/18/38. 07/18/38.
Yep.
07. Did it say why that was the password?
Yeah, it did. Like, you get a bunch of different clothes and stuff. Ooh. Oh. Well, that's not gonna backfire on us at all, is it?
I think it's the door over here.
Yeah.
What were the clues?
I mean, let me see. Luckily, no one listens. Do you need to you need to check around his office, go to the corner to the right of the door to find the date when he and his wife first started as the co-heads of the research foundation that provides you with the first four numbers. The last two can be found on his desk where his daily calendar mentions that actress Heidi Lamar was an inventor and notes her age.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I did find a level 1 security card.
Oh.
inside the room.
Okay. Is there anything sus in there, or was it just the card?
Just the card and a few more.
Yep, July 18th. And then you got the 38th.
Okay. That, I don't know, that felt like it was really...
convoluted?
Mm-hmm.
Or not convoluted, but, like, specific.
Yeah.
Which is probably for the best, if you think about it, because they are supposed to be changing these things daily.
Yeah. Okay, so we have multiple options. Let's try floor negative one at first.
My bad news detector started going nuts. Estevesta team, something's going on in the lake house. I want all nearby agents to...
Oh my god! Oh, of course the power's out. Oh, that's great. At least she made it to the level.
Agent Estevez, what's your status?
Oh my god.
Breach detected in Sector 5. Staff should seek shelter immediately.
We have a situation in the lake house. All agents converge on the facility now.
That escalated quickly, and we only got down one floor.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Relay that order.
Shit.
What happened? What is that?
It's event. Is it paint?
Yeah.
It was the Marmont's problem. Our mission was outside.
So your map's updated. Oh my god.
Okay, so they said it. So the alert was a sub breach, was a breach on level 5.
Yeah.
And in the original one, we found a emergency seek shelter. And in the in the main game, we found the one page describing one of the scientists being like in awe as like darkness consumed him.
Yeah, it was Jules Marmont too.
So yeah, we must have arrived just as the experiment went horribly wrong.
And also, too, in the original Alan Wake, there was somebody, one of the people at Cauldron Lake Lodge, who was a painter.
Need to get back to the elevator.
Sub-level 1, painting production.
And he was...
Where's the fucking elevator?
What?
Oh, my God!
Oh, not this again!
Oh, no. It's like... Oh,
okay. Priority one, get the lights on.
Okay. Standing God, it's like you're in some sort of overlap.
You're not smart?
Okay, so she knows. She at least knows some of the stuff.
Yeah, and if she knows about the FPC, she probably knows about building shifts. It just doesn't make sense that they're happening here.
Yeah. The guy from... the guy, I don't remember his name, and it's bugging me, but he was a painter, and he was painting a lot of dark material. And as such, and in fact, even when there was a tie-in comic that said that when the darkness started to overtake, he was painting, and he could not stop.
Yes.
And he actually did get attacked by... a taken Ben Motz, the kidnapper from the original game. However, there is a document in Control that does say that he survived, so I wonder if he's the person involved.
Probably.
Okay,
progress note. The work to create a stable link between our reality and that of the blank continues. Progress is good. All teams reporting high confidence that a successful connection will soon be possible. Oh, they were trying to connect to the dark place. I'm betting. Recent efforts in utilizing the paintings produced by Subject P to adjust reality in such a way that achieved our goals were unsuccessful. However, this result allows us to discard that avenue of research and focus solely on a more viable one. Mm-hmm. Our new hypothesis is that the threshold energies and thus its reality-altering effect are drawn towards pieces of art that contain significant level of emotion.
Oh.
This is supported by a clear trend in the data we have gathered over the years. We can identify and quantify the emotion of an art piece. Our work will speed up considerably. Work has already proceeded with an intermediate focus on developing devices capable of measuring the level of emotion in any given piece of art. For now, our research will continue to focus solely on the art of Subject P. While no pieces of his have yielded successful results outside their assistance in discovering the blank pages, his proven status as a para-utilitarian makes his work the most suitable for research material. Refer to this file for the full reports.
Oh my god, is his work helping them reveal
pages? Maybe
for Alan's.
Yeah, that's a problem.
Oh god. Alright, research order. As the lake house continues to make progress towards its goal, various avenues of research are being pursued. Recently, one such avenue has yielded unexpected results. The research into nursery rhymes, directed by Dr. and Dr. Marmont, led by Dr. Campbell, as an art form, has shown viability in its ability to connect with the cultural like threshold. That they probably picked that up from Saga.
No, they were setting them up and then Saga found them.
Yeah, but then Saga was connecting with them and then actually made them work, so they probably remember that's actually...
I'm saying that they may have already known something about it, but then they just hadn't worked it through.
As a result, the nursery rhyme findings will now be carried forward by the co-heads of research and incorporated into ongoing research across the lake house. Effective immediately, research teams will be briefed on how to utilize the effective elements of the nursery rhymes in their own work. Note, Dr. Campbell and his team are being reassigned. They will continue to develop their work on nursery rhymes outside the lake house. Any exposure risks related to performing confidential work outside the facilities premises have been acknowledged and signed and accepted by the co-heads of research.
So he must have been the one that Mr. Dorr sent to the dark place.
Yeah, we knew that.
I couldn't remember his name.
He was on the other com, yeah.
Also, thank you, person, for following. And again, see the rules. We do not accept direct Twitch friendships over chat, but you are free to join the Twitch channel that is listed in the Discord. Yeah. Or that is listed in the Twitch channel. You're free to join the Discord. Safe room.
Oh.
Open. No one's inside.
Oh, we're just hoping it doesn't shut on you. Oh, look. Coffee. Okay. Oh, my God. Good. Just what we need. Coffee.
This must be... Yeah, this is probably going to be... This is a safe room. Hooray. Oh,
God. I hope Ati shows up.
Ooh.
What'd you get?
Flair for the dramatic.
Oh, sir.
I regret nothing.
No, you don't.
And you don't have the man's gun.
I do have a potassium pillow.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, hi! Hey, it's you!
Darling.
Yeah.
Wait, he's... A, in the main building, and B, definitely not here.
Mm-hmm. Well, last we knew, he was in the dark place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's what I mean. It's like he's... You know, this is a problem.
Yeah.
Well, you know, another problem.
Yeah, let's face it. The FPC doesn't do singular problems.
Yeah. Okay. I don't know where the power is. I don't like all these giant painted walls everywhere.
I know.
Okay, that just leads us back to the elevator. So we're gonna have to go around this way because all these things are blocking our way this way.
I wonder what they meant when they said that the paintings contained a high level of emotion.
I don't know. Just gonna stay over here in this little red box.
Power core receiver.
Nice, okay.
Finding a core in should get the lights on.
Okay, so I guess we need to find a cord somewhere.
A core. You said cord.
Oh, I thought she said cord, as in C-O-R-D. Okay.
Yeah. I just know for a fact something is going to jump out of one of these walls and try to murder my face.
Oh, well, that's rude. It can at least murder, you know, like your hand or something. Why does it have to be the face?
Because they're monsters. Oh, look at that thing.
Oh my god.
That is not a regulation FBC weapon.
Wait, what is she looking at?
Can't open it from the side.
Whoa. Over there.
Oh, my head.
What on earth is that thing?
Something that I bet you get to pick up later.
Yeah, it needs power. Oh, I need a level 2. Darn. So I'm stuck with my pistol for now. On the plus side, I have an adorable cube.
Hi!
Oh, no, first.
Ooh, hang
on. Jules' key card. Could be useful.
Interesting. Progress update number 6. Unfortunately, Jules' key card went missing last night. Huge shame. On a totally unrelated note, I now have a level 3 clearance card in my office plus a lot of black rock. Oh my god. I've been grinding the black rock down to a powder and stashing around just in case any gets confiscated. Next step, weapons test using black rock powder. If successful, maybe send schematics to offsite teams. Could lead to a transfer out of the shell. Need to think of more applications for black rock now that I have some. There was a researcher at the oldest house who had a ton of ideas like this. Wish I could remember their name.
Okay, so pick up a power core, align with the receiving, and insert it.
Okay. Let's see how this works. Yeah.
Make these things lighter.
It's a lot easier. Yeah, it's a lot easier for her to, for Jessie to pick these up with her telekinesis.
Yeah, and just yeet it.
The way I saw it, there was only one way out. Identify the source of the event and contain or eliminate it. Now, good news, I just had to keep going down.
Oh, good lordy.
Bad news, the elevator liked to disappear.
Also bad news, the closer you get to the murderous thing.
Yep.
Okay. Beautiful.
Turn on the power, please.
Vault in the system. Congratulations. Oh, boy.
At least the elevator's back.
Why is the lighting, even the backup lighting, keep all, like, creepy and dark and green like this? It looks like they're underwater. It's like the type of lighting you'd see in the deep sea floor of an aquarium, and I don't like it. Oh my god, it's a safe room.
Yeah. Well, yeah, there was a safe thing in here.
I know, but there's a difference between, like, okay, look, I know in the original game, any coffee thermos was in an actual safe room. I did not know if this exact same kind of mechanic would happen here.
That's fair, I guess. Okay, what's this do?
Oop. It does a thing. Sounded like something opened, just not sure what. Oh, here we go.
First off, a huge thank you to everyone here.
You're welcome.
The lake house has made amazing strides in researching AWE here in Calder Lake. Great work, team.
Oh my god.
I wanted to come in person so I could check in on the latest work. I won't get the way. It's not our view, so no reason to be scared.
This must be another video.
Hear that, Dr. Robot?
Yeah.
While I'm here, I want to focus on the relationship between the Shadow and the AWE side of the world. The theory that the Shadow even originates from the dimension this threshold is tapping into is compelling. Eventually, I want to understand how this dimension manages to convert subjective elements like art into objective reality. What are the constraints of this phenomenon? Can it, say, create altered items or even objects of power simply by manifesting them via a piece of art? These things accurately classify the Shadow. I mean, that name is not very scientific. I mean, who came up with that? Shadow.
Could be worse. Could be the hiss.
Any and all proposals are welcome. Anything testing art's effect on reality by using the Shadow's energy is preferred. To find answers, we'll first need a lot of data. No wrong answers. And when I return to the oldest house, I'll take back anything we end up with to run against a classified project called Hedron to build a comparative data set. I wish I could tell you more. It's a very, very exciting
Oh, he mouthed classified.
Yeah.
Clearance, of course, but that, you know what? I don't want to take the entire day talking. So, the shadow represents a whole new area of research, and I couldn't be more excited to start doing it. It is a brand new world
before. I do want to get my hand on that Blackrock gun. Because I don't know what this thing did. And I can now interact with it again, so.
Yeah.
Oh, computer.
Oh, hello. Attention all staff, there's a significant amount of Blackrock missing from sub-level 5. I expect there is a misunderstanding and someone has taken it to another floor by mistake. If you did this, respond to the message and we will fix the problem. Blackrock is a precious material. We only have so much of it now with the oldest house being closed. Perry, do not release any of those pages. Tell Diana and those fools on Project Arbitus that we misplaced them. An unfortunate filing accident. Tell them we are confident the pages will resurface in 2 or 3 weeks, but we are too busy making progress to look for them right now. Be sure you say that we are making progress just as I wrote above. Oh my god, he's lying to his wife.
Yeah.
Sensitivity reminder. Hello, a gentle reminder that nut allergies are a serious health issue and making light of them is not appropriate workplace behavior for anyone on any seniority level. Bringing nuts to the office is a health risk and should be avoided for everyone's safety. Thank you, Harry Kingston, Facility Administrator. Well, yeah.
Hello. Pie Day! To celebrate the arrival of fall, I have brought a variety of seasonal pies from a local diner. You will all seem to love so much. The members of the Project Ramus can enjoy them in the lobby near my office. All other staff should visit the other Dr. Mamet's office to see if she brought a pie. Also, despite the ridiculous dramatics of last year, I have purchased delicious pecan-filled pies. Happy fall.
Oh, security reminder. Hello, please remember to lock your computer before leaving your station for any amount of time. Changing your password daily does not improve our facility's security if you leave your computer open. Thank you, Brian Lopez, IT specialist.
Meanwhile, his computer was left wide open.
Well, in all fairness, something may have happened to them. There was also a file on the desk next to the computer. Oh, wait.
We read that one.
We did read that one, yes. Oh, it looks like there's faces in the painting, but I don't know if they're actually supposed to look like faces. Or if that's just, you know, the human ability to recognize faces on anything.
Okay, the elevator is not in that... Oh, the elevator is now over here.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Okay. Oh my god.
Oh god. Bullets didn't work. The flashlight didn't work.
Oh my god.
That scared the heck out of me.
Oh my god, me too. Okay, okay.
I don't remember if I can dodge or not. And I just did it myself, I think. Oh, no, I didn't.
Oh.
We went back into the painting.
Okay, so at least that means that for the time being, it won't seem to come into these side rooms. Maybe it doesn't know how to duck. It's too tall to reach the doorway.
Oh, there's a lot of storage items nearby. Where'd it go?
Sounds like it's walking on wet paint, which is probably the point, but it's so unsettling.
Game, zoom in. I'm trying to look for items.
Yeah, you're okay, you're okay. Just, oh, I hate that this thing seems to know where you are and when you've left its vicinity. It's when you've left its vicinity.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god. Oh, here we go.
Yeah, I found the elevator, and it doesn't look like there's a way to get a second key, a level 2 key card yet.
It's not yet.
I'm gonna try and go back for that trauma pad.
Okay, good luck.
Wish I remembered how to dodge.
Oh my god, there's two of them.
Mm-hmm. What does this say? Panel control switch. Okay, maybe that... Oh, that must have moved the panels so that we could get to the elevator.
Oh.
Because this, I think, was in the way before.
Yeah, I think you're right. Ah! Okay.
Fuck, were those things?
The painted. They were? The painted. Yep. Let's... Oh my god, let's get out of here. Oh, we can't go back up.
No, we can only go to 2 and 3.
Oh, boy.
Okay, so we're going to go to 2. We're going to look for the level 2 security cards. We can get the Black Rock gun, because I imagine that's going to be effective against these things.
Oh, she's doing deep breathing.
Look, you never really get used to the shit you see in this job. You can learn techniques to adjust, to function. Take 6 deep breaths. Then get to work. Find the source. Collapse the threshold.
Yeah.
Please hold. Please hold. Please hold.
Please hold. Who is
that?
Oh no.
We're not on the floor.
Oh my god, this is the hallway from the trailer.
That painting is moving.
Uh-huh. Oh my god, you could talk to it.
Federal Bureau of Control.
Oh, no.
I can assist you if you take no hostile action against me or any action that can be perceived as hostile. Do you understand? Well, I'll be damned.
Okay.
So what kind of entity are you? Speak.
Yes, we knew that.
It means you probably imprinted on a person or retained some of your former self's information. Previously human, maybe? Okay, I can work with that.
Yep,
I just had an unpleasant encounter with some other painted individuals. Any relation?
Probably.
What does that mean?
Oh, it's just running.
Hey, calm down!
Oh my god.
You need to cease all hostility right now!
Whoa! Where am I?
Thing is really pissed off.
Okay, we're still in the...
It didn't try to kill me.
Yet?
Okay, so we are in a hallway that is between floors and basically does not exist in the building.
Okay. Okay, if I knew it didn't try to kill me. Yet. Oh, we can go back up to level 1 now if we want. Okay.
Do you want to try?
Angry living paintings are not typically on the Cauldron Lake bingo card. Something different was happening at the lake house, and I couldn't let it escape.
Valid. Don't do that! Oh my god! You don't have infinite bullets! You don't have the security thing! What are you doing? What are you doing, sir?
Getting content. Doc, I deserve that!
Yes, you did! I'm
Oh, elevator's gone again. It's probably just back over at the other side.
Ah, crap. Okay.
On the plus side, there's a box right near me.
guy. They're still here, too.
Oh, yeah, and there's one right there. The one right there. Oh. Walls. Sorry, I tried to go for items.
No. You're fine. Look, like, you... Look, this is not, like, the thing where you have all of the, Okay. This is not like the other one where you have all of the items here, okay? I know your resources are limited. I know you need to suck up because you don't know what you can do. I just don't like those things.
Agreed. I probably could have used a flare, but we also don't know how effective that would be.
Yeah, and don't you only have one flare?
I have two. Okay, I found one in a box, but...
Yeah, you may need it if we actually come across Taken.
Okay, let's actually try floor two.
That's a bubble. Oh, yeah, she just said this isn't the one I wanted.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's... This was... Okay.
Okay, so we are on sub-level 3.
Cool.
Big open area over here.
Probably with more paintings.
Well, maybe we'll find a way to actually kill them.
Page development. Oh, I bet we're gonna find manuscript pages down here.
Maybe.
Or at least references to them. Hello. Hi, guys.
There's some more painted monsters.
Not actually paint down here yet, so that's a good sign.
Emergency, yeah.
Ooh. Okay, refinement process. The automated typing device ATD will produce writing mimicking that of Alan Wake, known para-utilitarian, with the goal of affecting reality with the same consistency as Mr. Wake's writing. To reach this level of authenticity, each page produced by the ATDs must be evaluated and graded based on its similarity to Wake's original style. The pages will be graded using the following criteria. Comprehensibility. This is the most basic of criteria. The page must use language and develop stories in an understandable, organic way. Style. The page must accurately mimic the typical style of Wake's writing using pages in the Lake House's possession as reference. Tone. The page must accurately mimic the typical tone of Wake's writing using pages in the Lake House's possession as reference. Content. The page must accurately mimic the typical content of his writings using the pages as reference. Once pages are graded, they will be fed into the algorithm as preferred reference material, thus continuously refining the writing produced by the ATDs until they can produce near identical stories to Alan Wake. Once that is achieved, we will use instructions to the ATD on what to write, effectively gaining control of Wake's ability to link with the Shadow's power. Can I just say, this is basically the control equivalent of ChatGPT, and I am not about it.
It also wouldn't work. It would lack the emotional aspect that Wake's writing had.
Not to mention, you know, oh yes, we want to add up more of the content and the tone and the action, and it's like, no, you don't want to do that, because then you're just inducing more and more of the horror stuff he's being forced to write. We don't want this.
Yes. Organizational update. Moving forward, research at the Lake House will be divided into two distinct projects. Project X that. Code. Artibus will focus on studying the writing of Redacted, with Dr. Diana Marmont serving as project director. Project C, codenamed Ramis, will focus on studying Redacted and his work, with Dr. Julius Marmont serving as project director. That must be the painted one.
Yeah.
Staff will soon be notified regarding their project assignment and any required desk changes or paint shift is required during this reorganization. This is a confidential facility matter and is not to be discussed with external agents or teams. If you have any questions, please contact the director.
Oh my god, the AW, that probably means Alan Wake.
Yeah.
And the other one, if you're right, that's the painting. Jules is in control with it. That is what led to his whole discovery. So he did something.
Yeah.
Or he let something happen. This is probably Diana.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh no.
Oh no. Oh, that's so bad.
Yeah.
fascinating. Oh. What? Yeah, that has to be Diana. She wouldn't refer to him so familiarly.
Familiarly. Don't know anything about that.
September 12th. Maybe it's referring to the Bookers.
Maybe.
Because Tammy is a true crime writer.
Diana and
Hi.
Oh.
Words per sentence. Max 15, minimum 1, average 6.41. Style, character centric, lane. Past tense, clipped phrasing, higher adjective usage, focused timeline.
Story concept, runoff lane, paint, odor, Marmont's hate and conflict.
Oh, Rudolph Lane, that's the name of the painter, I think.
Yeah. Diana and Jules Marmont had once been a team, rising stars of the Bureau, both talented in their own way. Diana innovated and Jules got funding from the bureaucrats. Cooperation led to respect, connection. Then, after a decade of high rise, a happy couple were promoted, co-heads of research. The first year at the lake house were good. Challenging, but not insurmountable. Not for them. Gradually, thoughts fell into their heads like drops of dark water. Why does she get all the credit? Why does he get any credit? With that, a crack formed in the lake house. The Merriments and their work became arrogant, erratic. The crack widened and the water seeped in.
Oh, no. Oh, so bad. Okay.
Contains dialogue, phrasing, third-person omniscient, broad timeline. Lake House, Conflict, Water, Dark. Sorry, a lot of this is just small stuff. Co-head, one word or two.
Valid. Yeah. Okay, Rudolph Lane stood back from the canvas. He didn't recognize the piece. Did he paint this? His mind was foggy, unfocused. He knew the Marmons were putting something in his food. A man in a white coat came to steer Lane back to a cell. He did not resist. He was too tired. He lay on the bed, but the stench in his cell wouldn't let him sleep. An acid stink. The turpentine. The paint. It was all over him. Years of it. 1,000 paintings. 1,000 more to come. A putrid weight he could never wash away. Cold hate simmered below the mist clogging his thoughts.
Oh. I was reading it.
Oh my god, we didn't realize because the fan was going. But yes. Yeah.
Hatred for the brushes, for the Marmons, for himself.
Oh, no, the 1,000 paintings, that's what the angry murder painting was talking about.
It must be Marmon.
Yeah. No, I think it must be Rudolph.
Oh, yeah, Rudolph, sorry.
Rudolph Lane, yeah.
Man.
Really? Really?
You go through the trouble of marking a box on my map, but then don't give me anything.
Oh, that is so rude. That is so rude. Got a point.
It's just gonna repeat itself, or
no? Maybe.
There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in.
Okay.
But the water.
Okay. Initial findings report. Edward Franklin Booker.
Yes.
Born in New York. Currently resides in New York. Married to me.
Tamitha
Booker. No known children or dependents. No practical affiliations found. Okay, and Brooke Falls, WA, as of 9/10/23. Writer and director of 5 stage plays unsuccessful. Confirmed artist, designation, author, playwright. Background investigation performed in a very short amount of time per instruction. As a result, information contained in the report was not comprehensive and possibly erroneous.
Okay. Project Arbitus, Tamitha Booker. Born in Atlanta, Georgia, currently resides in New York. Married to Edward Franklin Booker. No known children or dependents. No para-criminal affiliations found. Located Bright Falls, same day. Author of 3 commercially successful true crime books. First publication was Poetry Collection, unsuccessful. Confirmed artist, designation, author, poet.
And just errors.
Yeah. Again, possibly erroneous.
Were those the first people that we interviewed in, that saw the murder nonsense going down?
Yes.
Okay, just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, they were the ones who found... They were the ones who came across what happened with Nightingale. Then you talked to them in the... Then you talked to them in the diner over coffee and pie, and Tamitha was just like, can I go scream into a pillow now? Okay, thanks, bye. You know, the usual. The usual.
For Cauldron Lake, definitely the usual.
Oh my god, yes. How does anybody still live here?
Empty box.
Rude.
Okay, so let's...
Can we go check the whiteboard by the projector? I want to see if there's something we can read there.
No, just output.
There was a crack in the lake house.
Yeah.
The Marmots had let the lake in. The water.
Typewriters. Please don't let this be what I think it is. As you know by now, typewriters and Cauldron Lake do not mix.
Look at the lights.
And a room full of them all clacking away. 100% bad news.
Oh, they're all writing automatically.
Mm-hmm. Look at the, we have, like, those big, like, the type of lights you see on a photo shoot. Probably in case any taken show up.
Yeah.
Rude.
I understand now why the doctor was so excited in his journal. It's like, we connected to the dark place! It's gonna murder us now.
Yes!
Oh, okay, that's one first.
Okay. This is from June 2022. Investigation into the precise brand and model of typewriter used by Alan Wake, with the intent to use this particular brand for a redacted and the ATDs, continues to be unsuccessful. Sources contacted with discretion. Wake's publishing house. Result, no useful information. Wake's agent. Result, refuse to discuss client matters. Wake's spouse. Result, refuse to discuss. Redacted. Result, no useful information. Check all available online interviews / publications / elements pertaining to Alan Wake. Results, no useful information. The relevant team will continue to explore alternative sources of information. The ATDs will continue to be operated with the available typewriters until Wake's preferred brand is known. Theoretically, replicating Alan Wake's style of writing via the same brand of typewriter used by the author should yield optimal results. The project director has indicated that a similar investigation should be launched into the brand and type of ink used in Alan Wake's typewriter. Oh my god, they even tried to get Barry and Alice in on this,
And we don't even know how much Alice would remember of all of this.
No, but I have to admit, when they say, like, checking with the redacted, useful information, I wonder if that's supposed to refer in any way to Hartman. Probably not, the dates don't match up, but you never know.
Yeah. Also, I don't like this room. I don't like this room.
Valid. Fair. Just the emergency.
I need level 2.
This key card won't get me in.
Okay, so I'm still searching for a level 2 key card. If we can't find it down here, then we're going to have to head back up.
Hello.
This room's not on the map.
Oh, that's always... Oh, there's paint. Oh, there's paint. Okay.
Can I explore around a little bit more in here, then? Oh, it's just...
It's just one of the lights.
No, it's just like a pole or something.
Hello.
Yeah, we'll do this first. Wow, they got him quick.
Mm-hmm.
Complete disregard for proper scientific methods. But he was bold enough to try something we hadn't.
Oh, no, don't compare that to you.
But we could understand the effects of Cauldron Lake's threshold much better by observing live.
Oh, no. That's how they got Rudolph.
Next step.
Oh, God. Because nothing bad has ever come from keeping people in an FBC thing.
No.
reply, R.E., Dylan.
Yeah, research notes. Content of Wake manuscript. We have begun to find pages from a manuscript very likely written by Alan Wake, peri-totalitarian and suspect for past cases involving Cauldron Lake AWE. Though I do not like to bring myself or my bias into my work, I must do so here to address the matter being examined. As reference for any of my future readers, I am Dr. Diana Marmont, co-head researcher of the Lake House. The page was recently found summarizing my life with Jules Marmont, husband and co-researcher. It has turned us into characters for his story, making generalizations and assumptions that I must attempt to evaluate without emotion or prejudice. Mm-hmm. The accuracy of the writing is intriguing. It reports our past in the Bureau, but also details inner thoughts that an outsider recorder would have no way of knowing. Jules and I have indeed been having more and more interpersonal conflict this past year. This raises many questions. How does Wake, whether in his writing form, get this information, or is the page itself determining these emotions and events? I cannot believe the scope of Wake's ability goes so far as to have dedicated my entire career to the FBC. And if it did, would it matter? Even if a person knew their life was being driven by an existential force, would it change their nature, their behavior, their personality? My disagreement with Jules are not sudden shifts in personality, but rather a growing resentment. I firmly believe that, though I have no evidence to prove it, which brings me to a new research query for our team. What methodology can one use to prove that their actions, their mind, their love, or animosity are theirs to control?
You know, she does have a good point.
Yeah, and for people like these, they definitely don't have sagas.
Seer powers.
Yes, or abilities to, you know, control themselves and... Mm-hmm. Okay, I think for the moment, this room is relatively safe. But there are two level 2 doors that I can't get in yet. So... And the only other place we can go is down the hallway with the paint.
Okay.
I know, I don't like it either, but... Okay.
I have to admit, I didn't... Hi.
It's also not on the map.
Well, hey, the other painted hallway we had where we saw the guy wasn't on the map either. Hello.
Wait, what?
The wraparound hallway. Oh, no.
Shit.
Oh, there's something in the floor there.
Never say no to extra firepower.
I got an extra...
Even if you take it off a bloody floor.
Yeah, I got an extra, what's it called?
Shotgun? Hunting rifle?
No. Inventory row.
Oh. Okay.
You pick up... Where am I on the... I did loop around. I'm right back where I started. But now there's two dead bodies here.
Oh, and that blood is so red.
Huh. Back where I started.
Looks so fresh.
Spatial recurrence usually observes the law of 3.
That's true.
This contrived overlap rebounded on itself.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Compressing, compounding.
Oh, it changed.
Yeah, it has.
An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance. Cause and effect hopelessly tangled. Arranged wrong, the dream logic flawed, the feedback loop doubled and redoubled out of control. The pressure kept building, looking for release. This contrived overlap.
Do you remember?
Itself, compressing, compounding.
Yeah, those are the same.
Reflecting,
yeah.
And refracting.
You remember when Saga had to go through the loops and the overlap?
Yeah.
And every time she went through...
Things changed.
Yes, that's probably exactly what's happening here. Oh. Oh my god.
Oh, no. Down one speedy bugger. Ow! Oh, God. Ow, axes. Oh. guys were tough. No. Even see that one.
Rude. The painted can move across painted surfaces. Pay close attention to the figures on the walls. I mean, okay. Just, you know, in case.
Mm-hmm. I don't remember if there's a way to dodge. Four shots and he goes down. Ow.
Whoa.
He was not here.
No, he's not. Oh my god.
I need ammo. Okay, that's one down at least. Ow. Really? I don't know if I'm just out of practice, but...
Some staff down there have been corrupted.
Yeah.
Shit just kept getting worse.
So I'm using a flashbang or something.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. The, They did all look like they were wearing FBC jackets or wearing corporate attire. They were still talking about, you know, like Deer Fest, the Expresso Express, but...
Mm-hmm. But they would know about it because they work in Bright Falls.
Mm-hmm. Or if they've been taken, they're chattering about what Alan was writing about.
Mm-hmm.
My god.
That was surprisingly more difficult than I thought it would be.
Yeah.
I know, that's the wrong button. Oh, there it is.
There's your dodge, okay.
It's L1.
L1, okay.
That's a random button, but I'm also just not exactly used to it given how I've played so much of Alan Wake 1.
Yeah. I tell you the truth. Watching Kieran practicing her dodging after you've eliminated the Taken threat is kind of funny. Just be like, just imagine anybody watching like any sort of feedback camera footage of this. Be like, what is she doing? Oh.
I will admit, I do prefer the flashlight mechanic of the first game.
Yeah, definitely. I want to actually let it recharge
if you didn't have batteries.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I did find a lot of shotgun ammo.
Okay.
But I think the paint is growing.
Yeah, that paint looks really fresh. Like, I think it was dripping down. These guys are...
Those guys are still here.
Oh.
Loop 3 should be the last one.
Do not copy manuscript pages. It says.
I hear creepy noises.
I do too.
I keep coming back to this page. The author's clearly awake. It's like he's warning us. But about what? I mean, what does it mean?
Oh, that was also in the trailer.
This page scared Jules away from the work on Wake's writing. Coward Science is risk. For me, this is proof that we are going in the right direction. I just need Rudolph Lane's paintings to lead to more pages so that hopefully one day we can understand.
I wonder if there's any significance to the fact that she says science with a capital S. I don't know if maybe she's referring to like the specific science department or something, but okay.
Okay, let's see what monsters we have. Oh, now there's a little item chest in here.
Yay!
And it has some normal bullets.
Okay. Oh.
What?
So the texture started to look a little fuzzy out there, but I don't know if that was...
Wait, what? Ah!
Oh, no.
Typewriters in all directions. This is gonna be fun.
Just, there's no more outer walls, is there?
What is that?
An overlap. That's what we're seeing, an overlap.
Oh my, yeah, well, that makes sense. Yeah, we got the looping, we got the,
What? Dylan's cell!
Dylan?
I think that was his cell, wasn't it?
I don't know, I couldn't tell if it was that, if it was something from, like, I don't know, it, or, oh my god, I don't know. I don't know what that was. Oh! Oh! Well, this is new?
The FBC.
You mean the oldest house?
Yes, really? we're in the oldest house right now.
There's an overlap leading to the oldest house. That's how we come across Dylan. That's how we come across Dylan, like in the trailer.
Yeah, but I recognize it. The bricks, there's paint in here.
Oh no. Oh no, there's paint in here. Oh no. Well, maybe if we're having an overlap, maybe Jesse will come and help.
Those pipes were blocking our path a moment ago because the lights were on.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It's like in the main game, as we move around and change the lighting, like what is in our way and what isn't changes.
Yeah, just like that. Okay.
And now if we look back, oh no, it's still broken over there, but so
still since it's in a new spot.
Won't open without power.
Okay.
I still don't like these noises.
I don't either. Because, you know, we don't know where they're coming from.
And we're also in the FBC of all places. And the power cubes are now surprisingly smaller. On the plus side, the power cubes do glow, which might help.
But I don't think they're glowing enough.
No. So that light's back on, the pipes block our way, but I saw a door on the other side that maybe we can now get back over there. Okay. Unless, what's this do?
Oh, the lever gearing.
Controllable shifting phenomena.
Yes. Okay, I saw a door here. Can we open this?
Yes. Oh, back into the typewriter room.
Okay, so I'm assuming we're going to probably need one of the power cells for something out here then.
Okay.
We needed that power cell to get this room open.
Oh.
It probably we can put the power cell back down there if we need to.
There, okay.
Okay, let's turn this back on. And then see what it looks like over there when the lights are on. Because maybe there's something else over there.
Okay. Ooh.
What's this do? Oh.
Oh my god. Okay. Okay, that's new. Okay.
Let's try turning them off again real quick, just to see what happens. Okay. Right,
okay. Let's go investigate this thing first, see if anything looks different over here. And then we can...
No, I think it's just we have to have power cells in both of the areas to activate this switch, which then lets us...
Go down a further painted hallway.
I think this painted hallway might lead to the elevator, though.
Okay. God, I hope so.
Oh, no, it's the... No. It's the painting.
It's the... What am I called? Hi. Again.
I think this is...
What happened to you? Did the people here do this to you?
Mormons. Probably. Yeah, this is gotta be Rudolph or connected to Rudolph.
Mm-hmm.
Alan Wake's writing is being studied here. Do you know anything about him?
Names don't matter. A thousand more to come.
They say clear communication is the key to any relationship.
Kieran! Not now! Not now.
Mormons before. Do they do this? Where are they now? Tell me where they are. Christ.
Okay.
It's fixated on the Mormons.
Oh, yeah.
What did they do?
This.
A lot.
And we're back to...
The elevator. Or, no, we're back to the, in-between, huh?
Yeah. All right, let's try to actually go to floor two now to see if we can find that level two security card.
Foreign reality and our own. Okay. Now, they all have their own rules, strange as they are. But the further down I went, the more chaotic this one got. Clearly, this was the Cauldron Lake threshold, but something was wrong.
Something was very, very wrong.
More wrong than usual.
She's got a point.
Yeah, I'm still thinking that part was either FPC related or there's an overlap directly linking us to the FPC. Please remain calm. Holding an observation. Please remain calm. If it says that again, I'm shooting the speaker.
Elevator's
door. Where'd the elevator go?
Level-wide lockdown is in effect.
Okay, let's... Okay, this is a bit more complicated.
Okay.
Compared to some of the other areas, but...
Oh, level-wide lockdown is in effect, and I am not calm in the slightest.
Okay. Ah, dead scientist.
Tim? Tim? Is Tim here?
Maybe we have to look around and see if we can find him, though.
Come on, buddy.
Quick file.
Okay. Retrieval order. Acquisition team is hereby approved to acquire additional research subjects for an ongoing study related to Project Arbitus at the Lake House facility. Prioritize outcomes as ordered below. Both subjects brought to Late House to study. Tamitha Booker, her work is more commercially successful, thus more likely to yield results based on proven cases. Edward Booker, less successful than Tamitha, but theater is more widely recognized as art than true crime novels. Observe the subjects at a distance and only move to acquire if the opportunity arises. Under no circumstances can this operation draw the attention of local law enforcement. Signed, Diana Marmont.
Oh, geez, they were planning to kidnap those guys before everything went wrong.
I hope they managed to get out.
I don't think they got them. Okay, great. Another locked computer.
Okay, cool. All right. September 14th. The first piece of content produced by the subject is severely disappointing. It is not remotely similar to the content to the Wake pages that we provide as reference. Why is it so focused on my marriage? Why is Jules the protagonist? Why is it set in an actual lakeside cabin? When what is happening to at the end? What the hell is in the sky? Did anyone brief Booker about the concepts he has to write about? The lake house? The shadow? We need him to match Wake's style exactly. It's not going to work if he has no clue what he's writing about. We need to get the sword. We need progress now. And why isn't he taking this seriously? When I spoke to him, I thought he thought I was an actor. I want him to understand how serious we are, whatever it takes. They did get them. Oh, assignment. Continue the story from page AW002. Match the tone, style, and content as closely as possible. The crack was an emotional one. A line right through their marriage, their foundation, their lake house. These thoughts and more flooded Jules' mind as he stared out through the lakeside college's window. The sun was setting on a stormy day. Rain-heavy clouds hung low, weighed down with the burden of purpose. Diana sat in her favorite deck chair, staring out at the water's rippling surface. He watched the breeze catch her acorn hair. As if sensing his gaze, she turned her head. Jules looked away, flustered, then annoyed with himself for letting her affect him this way. He grabbed the bottle of red wine, poured himself a generous serving, and he kept pouring, his mind distracted by a thought. How did we get here? They had been at the lab running an experiment. Then they were here. Why? He remembered thinking that a break from the lab would give them space to reconnect, to mend the crack. But he couldn't remember ever leaving. Wine was flowing over the rim of the cup, though he didn't even notice. He put down the bottle, scanning the lake. A faint shimmer hung in the air on the far side of the lake, like light hitting glass, the sort of thing you only notice if you're looking for it. He felt like he had seen something like this before, but where? Jules! Diana's cry snapped Jules back to the present. She was staring at the sky in a panic. A deep shadow crept across the deck. Jules ran to the door to his wife.
Finally, admit, someone who isn't a painting. Hey, hello. Who are you?
That's
Sorry,
Ed.
Sorry, got a flow going. Can we
That's
do this
Ed.
Later?
That's Booker.
No, we cannot. I'm Agent Kieran Estevez. I'm with the government, and I need your name.
I'm Ed Booker, the playwright.
Oh my god, they did get
and
him.
Hitting my
At least they
yeah.
got
here. So can you guys stop with all that banging and screaming? It's
We're trying.
Throwing me off.
Oh, he's...
Where do you think you are right now?
He's being affected.
Uh-huh.
In an immersive writing workshop.
Well, bad news. It's not a writing workshop. Good news. It's not a writing workshop.
Karen.
Right. It's a government facility studying the power of creativity. That makes way more sense.
What are you even doing? What are you writing?
Well, after you all abducted me in the woods, I've been working on this manuscript you gave me because you need it for some experiment or something.
Oh.
I kind of forget the premise. But, you know, I've had this block lately, and filling in the gaps of this story has really loosened me up.
Oh, no.
He's definitely under the effects.
I still have lots of room to play. It's a solid creative exercise.
Look around you. How is this a workshop?
You have to stay in character. I get that.
No!
You're in the theater business, too. And look, the sets, the costumes, all great in there.
Don't blame for shock about him. He's been abducted.
Sci-fi kind of way.
Been forced into a science experiment. Leave him alone.
Down the role playing like 15-20%. Just some professional advice.
Okay.
Sir, whether you are aware of it or not, there is a situation here. I need you to stay in your cell until I can resolve the matter. Okay?
I don't think he had any plans of leaving.
Got it. Hey, no one's been around with food for a while. I could go for some dinner when you have a second. Oh, and can I get my phone back?
No.
I want to call my wife. I don't know how Tammy found you guys, but she killed it. 5 stars all around.
Yeah, I'll get right on that.
Oh god, I do hope that Tammy's okay.
I think she might be in the cell over here.
Oh my god, you're right. Oh no.
What happened here?
What if she's... Oh no.
Jules Marmont looked at the painting. He didn't understand it. Saw only random whirls of color. Drug and Lane made him more compliant, but his work had turned abstract. Jules needed more art his team could parse, could test, trial and error. These abstract explosions of color complicated the data. His grip tightened around the letter opener in his hand. The piece of art he needed was hidden inside Lane. If Jules could simply cut the painter open and pull the painting out of him, he would. The overhead lights flickered. Jules would make Lane cooperate. No more drugs. Less carrot, more stick. Jules had to go faster. He wouldn't lose to Diana. Nothing else mattered.
What did happen to you, Rudolph? My God. Oh, no. All right. Subject, Project Randus, subject condition report, date redacted. Background information. Rudolph Lane, subject P, has shown a decline in redacted over the past several months. Initially, this redacted presented as an increase in resistance, frequently declining requests to work. However, given time and pressure, subject would always relent. Subject's attitude towards art has also undergone a change recently. He is disinterested in his work, quickly becoming frustrated and sometimes even damaging or destroying the piece before it's completed. In the past few months, his work has become much more abstract, no longer showing true-to-life subjects or landscapes, but rather conceptual art that is much harder to define or categorize. Whether this sudden shift in abstraction was a form of rebellion, a consequence of growing redacted, or a source of genuine artistic interest is unknown. Current situation. As of yesterday, subject refuses to touch his supplies. He claims he will not paint anymore and wishes to leave. The subject's refusal has effectively halted all research. While the team can continue to run tests on the backlog of paintings, they estimate that there is little new information to gain. The subject must continue to paint if work is to proceed. However, the team is concerned that convincing the subject will, with force or coercion, may only entrench him further in his position. Action to be taken. Dr. Jules Marmont and project lead has a co-head of research and project lead has suggested a high dose of redacted be introduced into the subject's food to cure his redacted. If the subject's attitude does not improve, then low doses of redacted will be introduced in order to improve his condition. Remember, the page did say that it was putting something in his food.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I know you want me to paint, but I can't. I'm empty.
Oh my God.
You love to paint. And you are such a talent.
Oh no.
This is just a classic artist slump. No. No. I hate it. It's just taking from me now. When can I leave? You said you'd let me leave.
Oh, no.
Rudolph, but you volunteered to come, remember? We are helping you, like Dr. Hartman did.
No.
Perhaps you need to see our doctor?
Oh, no.
I can arrange that. No. No, that's...
Oh, they're traumatizing the poor man.
He's terrified of the doctor.
Yeah, after what happened with Harmon, I don't blame him.
I can see why Estevez does not get along well with the people in research.
Oh my God.
They do not seem to have the same level of work order. While removal and transport, order by the head, work required. A section of the cell's southern wall needs to be removed for transport to sublevel 5 for analysis. Urgency high, tools required. It's not my job to know which tools of yours to cut concrete walls. It's your job. Additional details important. The wall must be removed very carefully. The painting on the interior side of the wall must not be damaged.
Oh, that's what this is. This isn't Tammy's cell. It's Lane's.
Yeah, he was painting something.
Maybe the painting he moved with... Uh-oh.
Well, open while the floor is on lockdown.
I think that's a taken... It said stranger. One of the taken that you saw on the other level said that. Oh my God, we're in the bathroom. Oh no.
I'm wondering though if maybe the, you know, the guy in the cell is saying it. What's his name? Brandon.
Ed.
Ed.
Yeah.
That's a vacuum cleaner.
Maybe it'll be a possessed vacuum cleaner later. We don't know.
Yeah, you never know with this thing.
I mean, poltergeists have not been much of a thing in this. Oh, hi. Hi, guys.
There's the elevator. How do I get in?
Okay, so that door's locked. Okay. So they can't get out at the moment.
Yep.
For now.
There's a level-wide lockdown.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna. I think that that area is on lockdown too, for level two, so can't go over there yet. On the plus side, I have a bunch of flashbangs I can use.
Oh, that's nice. That's always good.
Yeah.
Always good to have flashbangs.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna be using those.
Oh, you know what? I'm just remembering something. There is a page. I don't know if it's in the regular game or if it is something that you have to get from the final draft. Oh, hey, man. But, it talks about Ed being, like, Ed, like, he had an argument with Tammy and he left and he got taken in the woods. I thought it meant, hey, man.
Vandalized text. 0% effort today. Yeah, sorry. I didn't know that would happen.
I thought, I was thinking that he had gotten taken by, like, you know, by the, you know, had gotten taken by the darkness, but maybe he had gotten, that's just when he had gotten kidnapped by the FBC.
Maybe.
Oh, God, Tammy doesn't know.
No, they probably grabbed him on his own right before all this happened.
Yeah, because I think the page did say that they had an argument or he just left to clear his head or something, and...
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have to deal with all those guys once I lift the lockdown.
Forget level two. Oh, thank God there's a safe room. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, it's light time.
No. Granted, if this is kind of like an interqual, then Ed's only been here for a couple of...
Not even a couple days, because Saga met with him and then a single day doesn't pass.
Yeah.
So at the very least, it's probably only been a couple of hours. Well, we don't know what time distortion's like in this place, but...
No, I imagine it hasn't been super, super long. But even still, it's probably long enough that Tammy's worried. And something bad could have happened to her. I mean, mm-hmm. Hell, I was worried that if that cell was hers, what happened to her? But I don't mm-hmm. think it is, if that's Rudolph's cell. So that's at least a bit of a plus.
Yeah. Okay, I see a level 2 door there. And so I feel like this is going to be the only other place we can find a level 2. And we still don't have any other hints for that other computer out there.
Hi. She got a badge. Access card.
Yep.
Sorry, but I need this. Oh, my goodness. Sorry, lady. Oh,
another freaking password.
Yeah, here we go.
How many paintings did they have this guy make?
I know. Catalog of Rudolph Land Production. Alright. Designation, black circular shape among yellow lines. Description, an uneven circle painted in a dark black on the foreground with jagged yellow brown mustard. Lines behind it. Lines sometimes overlap with each other and or bleed into the black circles. Designation, lone tree at night, a dark green tree, pine, standing in a dark landscape, presumably night. Empty road and forest, description, a dark gray streak across a dark green landscape, presumably a forest at night. The gray streak is likely a road due to its location, color, and the way its width reduces in line with the perspective. A small white shape on the road could be a page of writing by Alan Wake. Relevant teams have been informed and are searching for this site now to attempt page retrieval. Designation, yellow crescent shape in black canvas. A curved yellow shape and a roughly crescent shape painted on an otherwise empty canvas. Possibly a crescent moon or banana? Unfinished piece? Oh.
Designation, yellow, red, yellow, and green, cute circle, three uneven circles, one yellow, one red, one green, roughly arranged in a vertical line. Background is black and gray with dark red streaks along the border of the canvas, possibly a traffic light.
Yeah.
Cityscape with blue-gray sky, gray vertical shapes, likely the skyline of the city, in the bottom third of the canvas with a vivid blue green sky, geometric shapes painted when thin white lines can barely be made out among the colors of the sky. Black void, a deep black void covering the entire canvas with a few small specks of dark or light gray able to be seen closer inspection. Sounds like the dark presence.
Uh-huh.
Large variety of black spirals.
Oh, no.
Large number of rough spirals painted in black, ranging size from that of a quarter to that of a basketball. So the canvas appears to be quite covered. It's blank aside from the spirals. Brown shape of horns, a brown shape vaguely triangular, with the presumably horns extending from the shape, likely an animal head, possibly a deer or elk, black background. Almost sounds like the,
Yeah. And honestly, too, the, What was I going to say?
Oh, sorry, real quick, what was the administrator code again?
The one...
Oh, the one we use upstairs.
071838?
It's probably not the same one.
No, it's not.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
My God. There's... Oh, is there something else on the floor over there? Oh, wait. No, turn. It's to the right. Look down. Oh, no. Okay, I thought that was an interactive thing. It's just like a computer mouse or something. Yeah, like the traffic light, the black spirals seem to be the ones in regard to, the black ones seem to be a, I mean, think about the spiral, the black spiral corresponds to the symbol on Alan's writing room, and the road in the forest could describe the road that it takes coming to get here. Hello.
Sorry, I'm trying to look down to see if there's any code to unlock the computer, but I'm not seeing anything.
Can you go back to the, go back to the documents and look at the one on the left side?
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to see if there was any specific, okay. I was wondering, because, I was wondering if there were any sort of, like, dates or IDs that did not have a, that didn't have any letters, but it doesn't look like it.
Yeah.
Do you want me to look it up?
Not yet.
Okay. But I wonder if the one that described the black painting, like, you know, the painting on the road, I wonder if that's meant to be...
Sorry, I had a feeling, but I couldn't be sure.
Hello, sir.
Would you... Oh my God, these guys I feel like are more durable than they should be.
Oh my God. Oh, hello. It's a calendar. Hello. 2023. Oh, like they have self-defense classes. Okay.
Yeah. It's all departments. Uh-huh. Like the September 13th, all passwords must be reset. American convenient. Recommend using a permit set of digits in the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just another thing with that.
I know this, yeah. September 2023. Perhaps this one is meant to... Perhaps we're meant to look at a certain day of the week. Oh, Piemaster's getting up!
I'm just trying to see, because there's a whole bunch of pins placed in random spots, but you can't really zoom in. The only thing I can see, there's a pin on the one, but that's it.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I wonder if that one painting that described the dark road is meant to actually be the road leading to the lake house.
Maybe.
Yeah, kind of a dark road going through the forest.
Yeah.
And then the three... Oh, my God.
Dude.
You dork.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. Here we go. Alright, 09-14-23. I made that reservation for our anniversary, which I certainly never forgot was a week from this Friday. Let's take separate cars from the office. Can't have the bosses see us leaving together. Now that those hypocrites have banned inter-office relationships, have a good day. Okay, go back to the calendar. Go back to the calendar. I think we can get this.
Hold on. Oh, it's a week from Friday, and this is written on the 14th.
Yes.
So, so this is the 16th, mm-hmm. And so it's the 23rd.
Yes. Let's try...
09-23-23?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh. I maintain that seeing a movie together does not begin a relationship. Today's password is the day of our special unforgettable anniversary plus brown shape with horns. Love you.
Oh, okay. So yeah. it's the 26th and
the 23rd.
The 23rd and then the number of the horns.
Okay. 44 is right, so yeah, I guess you're telling me you don't know when our anniversary is. Well, good luck with that. yeah, the Marms are losing it. Big surprise. I bet Diana set Jules' background...
to a big turd or something.
Once again, making their shitty management everyone else's problem. The password you sent didn't work. Black Void is 44, right? From the list of Lane's paintings, I need to get in or this is going to be a total waste of a Wednesday. Can you believe the new password policy? What security concerns are they even talking about? We are a fenced off government bunker in the middle of nowhere. I think they're getting paranoid. Anyways, I sent the security terminal's new password. Like the memo suggested, our anniversary is the base numbers, then Black Void. She has valid concerns that man is a tyrant. Speaking up about safety is no reason to fire someone. I knew it. She was way too vocal in last week's all-hands meeting. I just found out what happened to Trisha. Jules effing fired her.
Okay, so it's the big black horns, and then it's something 23. We need to see how many numbers are in the big black horns.
Yeah.
Document. Oh, now, okay, so the big black horns.
Yeah, that's at the bottom, I think.
Yeah, brown shape of horns.
25.
Okay, so it's probably 0923 25.
Damn it. Huh. 9 2 3 2 2 5. Oh, that was a good idea though.
It's something, and then where was Black Void?
Black Void 44.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah, we'll try it.
No. It. Oh, maybe. Yeah. Maybe they didn't change it.
Yeah.
Nope.
Okay. Let's go back to the anniversary one.
Mhm.
Because that's the first part of it. Yeah. So.
Week from this Friday sent on the... It is on the 14th, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's on the 14th. So, uh-huh. So yeah, a week from this Friday. So it
no,
is...
No. Oh, it's the 22nd. It's the 22nd.
Yes! The stupid thing is off.
Okay. All right, we got it.
092225.
Okay. There we go.
Why on earth would they set the calendar up like that? Because every calendar I've seen, it's always Saturday on the right, Sunday on the left.
Maybe it's a format, because Jules seems to not be American. Maybe it's a format from where he's from.
Yep. All right, well, and Auto Monster's out.
Oh, God.
Lockdown lifted. You are now safe to resume working.
Oh, no, we are not. We are absolutely 112% locked.
No, turn back. Area is extremely hostile. Fucking idiots. They're on floor one. We'll need help.
Oh, so we gotta go back to sub-level one.
Yeah.
Which, wanted to go there anyway to find the Blackrock gun, but...
Yeah. Okay.
Still not the best.
Oh, God.
By which I mean, everyone's gonna be dead by the time we get there.
I mean, yeah, I think so.
Oh, just gonna check the map.
Okay.
Oh, there's a container in there.
Cool. Ah, I wonder if Ati is responsible for these.
If we start hearing random singing, we'll know.
We did hear random. Okay, well, it was humming, but. And it was Ed, surprisingly.
Oh my God. Here, take that.
Nice. In the butt. Oh! Okay. Thought that was not going to work the way you wanted it to, but we're okay.
Oh! You're supposed to not have your shadow shield anymore. I threw two flashbangs at you. Eat this. Where'd they go?
They probably went back to where they were before.
Ooh. Okay. At least that one only took two hits.
You was the safe room, so even though the lights were off, I think it protected, I think it kept them from coming in after you.
Okay.
That's probably why he went back to where he was. This is a pretty well lit room. It's kind of freaky that they were in here too.
At least I found 20 shotgun shells in this drawer. Here. Rustic.
Sorry, he came
in. I know.
I expected.
Agreed.
Okay. Okay. Alright. We're doing great. Can you go? I think there's a whiteboard up there.
I know.
Yeah, yeah. Now that the monster seems to be gone. Oh my god, there's so much here.
The flash screen.
Oh my god. Scream, breathe. Breathing, 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 breathing.
Like, blah, blah, blah.
Comprehensibility. Tone D, content D. Okay.
The review program.
Uh-huh.
Too much overlap between tone and style. Merge. Word choice good but incomprehensible. Repetition issues tall, the sufficient rounds of refinement. Style of tone prioritizes over comprehensibility. Negative progress. Refinement plus time equals progress.
Okay.
Making progress again, individual. Elements are strong, but ATD is lacking awareness. Attention is a blocker.
Mm-hmm.
Game.
Game. Game.
Okay.
Need more awake info, critical. Okay. Dark scream the darkness, a dark reminder of the dark's interior darkness, a well of darkness, a vortex like black paint, darker and darker and darker. So dark the darkness could hardly see. A dark figure emerged from the darkness, facing the darkness with dark intent. A dark knife glinted in the dark darkly. Dark like the dark eye of a dark raven, dark feathers resting in the dark night sky. No moon, the moon has been eaten by the dark drank it, and the sun, the dark moon rose over the dark sun that had set into the darkest dark darkness. The darkness darkened darkly, darkening the dark dark
until it
over the dark darkest dark. Comprehensibility D, style C, tone A, content A, improvement.
Okay, well, let's not maybe read all them fully because I feel like they're just gonna be kind of.
Well, let's at least see how we're doing here.
Yeah. The rot snail beamed wooden giant banner for the owl egg.
Okay, no, we have to read. This is comic relief. We have to read these, okay?
Four forms in the glass, eyes and melt, cracked page booked through from down and bark. I grow and longer from the longer odds, dark sea, no one found egg male haven. Poor Doric out, he chased. Let all scream and blood. Axe vermin on, the day is round, flat across evening, water murmurs and light bulb trees, round the cat, the night clears all the streets, the coffee deers run, fear drinks locks like windy cottages, and black fires in the same mirrors. F.
Style and tone priority over comprehensibility, negative progress.
Yeah.
The dark woods rattled darkly. Flashlight peered into the deep darkness and the dark shivered. Flashlight scowled. A woodsman came with an axe. The woodsman's teeth screamed. Flashlight screamed too and was cut in half. Blood mixed with the darkness. A dark blend. Pistol looked at flashlight in shock. There was nowhere to run, he realized, but he ran anyway. He ran to the deep dark of the woods. The woodsman rattled behind them, bouncing through the trees. Pistol knew it had nowhere to run. Pistol drew his pistol and turned to face his death. The woodsman emerged and Pistol opened fire. Pistol's pistol flashed in the dark night. Once, twice, thrice, the woodsman fell with a clatter. Pistol breathed in and out, in and out. Pistol looked at each tree, in and out, he was safe. Pistol grabbed the woodsman's axe and plunged it into his pistol to charge it. It plugged it into his pistol to charge it. He went to check on flashlight. Pistol checked each half of flashlight. She was dead and he knew it. Pistol screamed at trees. The trees screamed back. Okay.
That wasn't so bad.
It wasn't so bad. Yes. So, making progress again, individual elements, the 18... Okay, so each note refers to the pages, yeah. Holy crap.
I still like that. The sentient pistol is mourning the death of its wife, the flashlight.
I know.
There's a painting here.
Hmm.
Wonder if that's part of the cell wall.
Maybe. Wonder if there's gotta be something in the reason it's covered. Oh! Oh. It was just the cart. You moved the cart and it sparked. Okay. Okay. Oh, hello. What do we have here?
Oh, that's not there.
Alright, this is Jules.
Mm-hmm. Always think about making this right.
Not well. Oh, that's why I love the pieces.
This must have been before they were being affected by.
Alright, the return girl will. Yeah.
Yeah.
I do wonder if some of it is because this was kind of making a loud, ripply noise, but.
Ma'am.
Oh, hello, ma'am. Whoa. Good dodge. Good dodge.
Stop reloading and fire. Thank you.
Good dodge.
Ow! I hate these guys. Yeah. Stop moving.
Who do you hate more, the zoomies or the axers?
They're the same guy.
Oh, are they?
Yes, the zoomies are the ones that throw the axes.
Right. Okay, then the answer is yes.
Yes, the answer is yes.
The answer is yes.
Oh, level 3. Okay, we need to remember to come back up for that. Sub level 2, there is a level 3. Oh, the store's open now.
Hey!
Ammo and batteries. Nice.
Okay. Oh, hello. All right. Reading report threshold activity. Readings collected over the last 48 hours show a rising increase in activity stemming from the cauldron-like threshold, likely indicating an imminent AWE scenario. The highest recording reading exceeded the safety limit, necessitating a general alert and requesting assistance from the assigned AWE response team. However, no alert or contact with external teams has been made per the recent amends to this procedure. As suspected, the monitoring team will take no action until sign-off from either Dr. Marmont or Dr. Marmont has been received. Considering the rate of escalation from that the
recent
data indicates, the monitoring team strongly recommends the AWE response team be contacted immediately, signed Harris Cross Lead Threshold Agents.
Why on earth would they make that part of the procedure? It's like, oh, you have to wait for the director to sign off. It's like, what if the director's unconscious or drunk?
And why are those the only two options? What if they are dead? What if they are being stupid? What if they have been taken by the AWE and you have a problem?
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, Ed. Are you okay?
Okay, he's okay.
Yeah.
We still don't know anything about this password, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wait. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I don't even see it.
I didn't either. We can have weekly gossip calls, promise. He really did that? Diane is gonna slit his throat if she finds out. Ha ha, those two are such a hot mess. I got drinks with Perry last night and he told me Jules is withholding wake pages from Diana's team. He told her they went missing. Crazy shit. Paula mentioned that you two were thinking about asking for a transfer. You'd really leave me here all alone?
Joel sent out a memo asking us to spy on his wife's project. Remember when we just made fun of his stupid project names and science factoids, Simpler Times?
Mm-hmm. Attention, missing Black Rock. Attention all staff, there's a significant amount of Black Rock.
Oh, we've seen this one, I think. Yeah, it's just the automated that's one.
Right. And then there was the Pi Day.
Yeah, sensitivity. Just a reminder that... Yeah.
Scary reminder.
Please remember to lock computer.
Okay.
Okay. I didn't mean to cut you off, but it's just like, oh, wait, we've seen that one before. Okay, so that one's security level 3. This one... Oh, they all came rushing out. The Saints came rushing out. Oh, no, sorry, the Taken came rushing out, not the Saints.
Yeah, remember, the Saints come arching in, the Taken come rushing out. That is how it goes.
Oh, wait, point of interest.
Ooh. Hello, what do we have here? Team Notice, as you may know, a value member of our team was recently reassigned off of Project Arbus. Carla Livingston's designs and engineering expertise were a key part in the creation of the ATDs. Their contributions to the project cannot be overstated. The project team should rest assured that their reassignment was an error that should be corrected soon. Our project director, Dr. Diana Marmont, would like to remind all team members that any directives or assignments from Jules Marmont have no bearing on Arbutus staff and should be ignored. Thank you for your attention. Well, damn.
Yeah. I wonder if that's what the point of interest is. Just, you know, like the documents. Because if so, we've already found that one, so.
Is there anything, like, on the walls? Like, is there another whiteboard in this area? Nope. Okay.
Just gonna search around for items. Oh, I accidentally closed the door with my frantic searching.
That's probably the best.
Oh! Oh, he came through the door!
Did you think you managed to shut the door on him?
Yes.
Excuse me! Sorry to intrude. Starting to intrude on your taking. I'll just leave it here.
Sorry, I thought I got them all. I didn't realize that he was still in here.
Well, you know, I think he was just having a good time. Oh, my voice is breaking. Okay.
Okay, I'll get this one.
Sure.
Background report. In 2010, Lane was inadvertently involved in AWE 35 while residing in Cauldron Lake Lodge. When it's found out the care of Dr. Hartman. See case note WA004 for information on his crimes and arrest. Wayne was seriously injured during the AWE. He received medical care in Seattle for 2 months, during which time he was questioned and cleared by FPC staff. After Cauldron Lake Lodge was seized and closed by the FPC, Wayne moved to Waterloo, WA, where he currently resides. Recent surveillance confirms he has no known personal relationship or affiliation with paranormal groups.
Okay.
As requested, the observation team has confirmed that Wayne continues to paint as of the date of the report.
Can you go back, actually? Can we see if there was a date on it? 2019.
Okay.
Okay, so...
Oh, and then there's this dead person.
Oh. All right, so we know that he doesn't have any known connection to the Cult of the Tree.
Yes.
Assuming the Cult of the Tree was founded at this point, but I think it probably was.
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
And, okay, yeah, there's nothing else, just that point of interest. But we found the elevator.
My team was on sublevel 1. I knew they were in danger.
Okay. Oh, they're gonna be dead, aren't they?
Oh, yeah. We have to go back up there anyway to get the Black Rock gun that we saw.
Turned innocent people into tools using the FBC's authority. They thought they were untouchable out here, hidden away in the woods. No. Actions have consequences.
Yeah.
And I'm the consequences.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, yeah. It seems like they were really going beyond what they were allowed to be doing.
Do you think that was Jules?
I don't know. It mentioned guy in the team coat.
It was.
Yeah.
He was taken by the shadow.
Oh no.
I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
Now the question is, will the art be in here? Oh jeez! That came out of the wall! Did it insta-kill me? No, it didn't. Fudge off. Oh! They're not affected by the flares.
Oh! I hate that.
I just want to get what's in that box, but I can't fight these things.
I know. Yeah, good thinking. Gave yourself a little bit of distance away from it.
Well, apparently there's something in here now, which wasn't there before.
Thank you, potential latte.
Okay.
Okay.
Go see if I can get to that Black Rock gun.
Okay. Maybe if the painting guys come out, you can kind of lead them in enough of a circle, and then eventually you can get to that box.
Maybe. I want to get... Oh no, the door's blocked. Oh, come on! I take damage while I'm in the middle of the cutscene thing?
Oh, that is really rude. But that has happened to you before. It happened to you when you fought Cynthia.
Stumble. Still,
yeah,
just
still
ball.
Really annoying, yes.
I mean, that thing is not very scientific. I mean, came up
I think
with
that's
that.
What you need.
Yeah, I think that it's gonna rearrange all of these out there, but then the door should be open.
I work on my house. This is my facility!
This is mine!
You cannot just walk in here for 1 week, make some speeches, and then fly back to New York. Espèce de crétin, prétentieux! Le Jackassix is a fucking rock star! And he made fun of the name. Oh, the shadow. The shadow is good. It's evocative.
Not really.
It's not any worse than Taken, though.
Mm-hmm.
James spoiled the child. I will make it so no one even remembers his name! To see his ABC in law,
buddy.
They all think I have a pencil pusher. I think I do not have the mind for such work.
Oh, you can see the flickers. Can you see that?
Uh-huh.
It looks like the visuals you get when someone's painting.
Whether or not this is Alan's interference, that guy was definitely had some unresolved issues and was losing it even before all this.
No wonder he ended up getting taken. We see what even a little blip
can do. I want to see if going back in here will help heal me a little bit.
Yeah, it is. Just a bit.
Tiny bit. Not nearly enough.
If you step out and then go back in, will it help?
No, I doubt it.
Supposedly, the figures on the wall should be where they emerge, according to that one hit. It's hard to determine what is a figure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so abstract here.
Okay, I'm gonna try this again. This might be my only hope at actually killing these things. Oh.
Okay. Oh, that was so close.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, okay.
Form.
Go ahead.
Got the firing mechanism working. It's throwing test projectiles a good distance. Turned out pretty nicely. The fittings between the grenade launcher and custom components are a bit loose. No proper lathe. Here, but at least it works. Yeah. Now I need some actual black rock for the test. I know there's some on sublevel 5, but the acting inventory supervisor doesn't get access to the floor. Next step, source black rock. So let's see what the heck this is. Level 3. I had to get in here anyway.
And this should get me past any other problems.
I just need to see if this thing can actually take on the painted. Trial and error.
By the black rock launcher.
Ooh. There was a crack in the lake house. Ooh. The Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. It became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. The contrived overlap rebounded on itself. Compressing.
Yeah, this is the page that Diana had.
Refracting. An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance. Cause and effect hopelessly entangled. Arranged wrong. The dream logic flawed. The feedback loop doubled and redoubled. Out of control. The pressure kept building, looking for a release.
And I may have found it inside Mr. Paint.
Okay,
that way's open. Nothing in there, really.
Oh,
nice.
Keep an eye out for one of these.
What does that say?
Poison is. Oh. It's. Oh.
Oh, I can
see it now. Oh, there you go.
1, 2, 1, 9.
Perfect.
Okay. I decided to raise Heine from Project Promos to Inventory Management. Your title will be changed from Senior Researcher to Acting Inventory Supervisor effective immediately. Find the change done, but I have no doubt someone with a nut allergy like you will prefer to work alone in the inventory booth than out in the open where any dangerous pies may be waiting to hurt you.
Oh my god.
This guy's an asshole.
Perhaps some hard work will keep you from making any more unfounded HR complaints.
The guy's mad because he refused to take the nut allergy seriously. Blackrock missing.
Uh-huh. In Kingston.
Yeah, and Pie Day. Okay, so I'm going to head out of this room.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try and get back to the save room.
Mm-hmm.
And if one of the painted does get in my way... Okay, let's see if this works.
Finally! Something works on these bastards!
Oh, I killed it!
Yeah! Yeah, it did say it needs a minimum charge to fire. I don't know if you saw that.
Yeah. Okay. It was panicked reading, but I saw something about charging, so...
No. Goodbye. Love it. Love to see it.
Oh, the music stopped. Okay, I'm gonna shift these things back around so I can get to that other box with items in it.
Oh, thank goodness.
Then I'm gonna save.
Uh-huh.
And then... Do you want to keep going, or do you think that this is a good place to stop
it
now?
It may be a good place to stop, because the next thing we do may take us a while, and I don't want to cut to... I don't want us to feel like we have to rush, and B, I don't want to put too much pressure on, like, getting ready for work.
Yes.
Yes.
So I'll get the box, okay. We'll save, and then next time, we will start by going down to sublevels 2 and 3.
Uh-huh. Now that we have the 3 clearance.
Yes, because sublevel 3 had a bunch of level 2 doors, which likely will have supplies in them that we'll need. And then, also I'm actually going to heal too, because I have really low health.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I hate those paint things. They are
awful.
They are just a pain.
Oh, they're so bad.
All right.
Oh, but this is so good. I mean, it's awful, but it's so good.
Let's exit to the main menu.
Excuse me.
And then I'm guessing we can just... actually, I'm just going to quickly test if hitting continue takes me back to that, to the lake house, or if we're just going to have to, like, choose load.
Okay. Okay. Sounds good. Okay.
Okay, oh, yeah, so hitting continue takes me back here, which is why I was warning about, like, losing progress.
Look at her, she has paint on her jacket.
Oh, she does.
I don't know if, all right, it's probably more like, hey, you know, she's been fighting and encountering a bunch of, like, paint creatures, but does kind of give the impression that something bad could happen from that, and I'm concerned.
Yes.
Her jacket starts to fight her.
Let's not think about that. Regardless, thank you everyone for watching. We hope you enjoyed this very creepy episode, even though it had a lot of reading.
You're reading a horror story, yes.
Yeah, that's fair. All right, but we hope you had fun and enjoyed the painted, creepy enemies, us being attacked by shadow monsters and me not knowing how to dodge, us reading a primitive chat GTP.
Oh my god. The dark reflected in the darkness darkly.
And we will see you all next time.
Good night, Internet.
Good night, Internet.